Hey guys, it's Carly at We Print Wraps. All right, so a question I've been getting a lot is how do you make a wrap design line up seamlessly between the hood and bumpers? This is a very hard one. It's not something you can get exactly done through a template. I can show you some tips and tricks on how to get it close, that make it more easy for your installer. Technically, I've kind of reached out to a couple other fellow designers that are a little more advanced than I am, and that I've seen online that have the most gorgeous wraps ever, and they have very good accuracy of lining up lines between certain parts of a vehicle. Have you ever seen a wrap where there's literally a line or something in the design that's going from one side of the wrap all the way to the other, and it lines up perfectly between the hood and the fenders? It's because they are actually doing a they're partially wrapping the vehicle and making custom templates. So they're customly wrapping the vehicle with white vinyl and then marking it with black Sharpie, and then they are taking photos or scanning in the template and uploading it and then making a custom template on their design program and making the art fit to that. So they know, since they've wrapped the vehicle and they took the wrap off, they can see exactly where the artwork needs to go. And we all know that's not easy and something that waste I mean, obviously, if you have a customer looking for that, it's gonna cost more. You're using material, it's a cost of time. It's just a lot of work. And there are some people out there looking for to pay that much for specialty wraps, but not everybody. And I myself personally, I do a lot more business wraps. People in the business industry, want to promote their business while they're driving around their work vehicles. So, right here on my screen, I actually have Pro Box, a design I did. And if you're wondering why the bedside's not wrapped, I'm going to go up here and show you. So here's actually the completed wrap. So it was an F-250 truck, but it had the flatbed on the back. I didn't have a template for that, so I just did the design on the front of the cab, to show them. Actually, this is something they came to us with, some artwork they had that they've been running on their vehicles, and they needed us to get it printed for them. So technically, when I'm designing, I like to just stay away from those areas. I don't like to put artwork up here on where the hood, the fenders are transferring to the hood, or on, cars have round bumpers, and I don't like to put artwork on the rear of the car where it's wrapping around to the back. I just try to avoid those areas just so it's easier for my installer, and then I don't have to line things up. And if something doesn't fit right or line up properly, then it doesn't have to be redone. So, but I was going to show you a little tip on this one. So, this design you can see has this half tone. Oops, didn't mean to drag that away. This half tone. It's actually, I did four layers this time. I'm going to go over my layers first. So I have my background. Let me zoom out. My background layer, which is the green background of the wrap. And then I have my clipping mask layer, is what everything I clipped and masked. And then my text. And then my template. Okay. So this pattern right here, it'd make more sense if we printed it to going onto the hood, since it's right here on the front fender. It's going up right here on the truck, and we want it to transfer to the hood. So my best advice to do this with a template is, I'm going to go ahead and zoom in here. That's in my mask layer. I'm going to go ahead and make a new layer on top, and then I'm going to hide. I'm going to hit the little eyeball and hide my mask layer, and now I can like better see the lines of the vehicle, and I see that there is. I'm going to pick a color. Right here is where the hood ends. And then the fender ends here. I'm just gonna kind of use this as a guide, and I filled it with red, and then I'm gonna bring back my mask, and then I'm gonna unlock it. And then I'm going to select my mask and that red box I created to help me line up on the hood, and I'm gonna Alt hold down and drag and let go to copy and paste, or Control C, Control V. Or edit, copy, paste. And then I'm going to go over here. So my clipping mask has more than just that dot pattern. So I'm going to go ahead and right click, release clipping mask, and I'm going to delete everything else but this halftone. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn it, since that's the way it would have been on the side of the truck, and I'm going to drag it over here. I'm going to line this red line up here with the top of the hood, like where it was on the side, and I'm going to kind of now, I can delete it and view. I can see over here where that half tone, it's kind of hard to see actually. Okay, I'm gonna maybe put some transparency on this so I can see what's going on. So the center of the circle's up here above the hood, that line of the hood is right there. So more than half of it is on the hood. So I'm gonna kind of just eyeball it and drag this over a little bit now that I kind of got it lined up better. And see how, okay, I'll do opacity on this too. More of the circle is on the hood, like it's not centered with this line, it's more shifted to the left, like it is on the side. Okay, so I'm going to raise the opacity back up on that. And I am gonna go back over here and change that back. So that's how you kind of transfer something over to the hood. And then if I were to do the other side, I would literally just take the same dot pattern and kind of drag it over. And then I would get it lined up exactly. Make sure it still needs to go up a little more. It's exactly where it is on this side, on that side. It could scoot over here to the left a little bit. I just do it my best, and then sometimes I'll take them and I'll group them. And I'll just make sure they're centered with the hood. So I can draw a line here for the center of the hood. And I just make sure that artwork, oops, the line didn't show, I need a push stroke on it. It's just these two circles are centered on this line. So then it's centered with the hood. And then I would go to the background color layer and I'm gonna copy the hood, Control C, and then Control B, paste in place on my mask layer. I'm gonna right click it, arrange, bring to front, because it needs to be in the front to make a clipping mask. And I would select it all, right click, make clipping mask. So there we go. That's what the completed would look like. And as you can see, if you go up here to the actual finished wrap installed, I mean, it's pretty darn close. It flows pretty good, and that's what's most important. It's very hard to get it 100% accurate due to vehicle lines and curves. I mean, you can tell here these circles are a little off, but in the end result, the wrap looks good, and it's not disturbing to look at because something's so off. So when doing this on the hood, my best advice is to, when I'm gonna make the panel for the hood and I'm gonna add the bleed, I'm gonna draw the lines just to show you. So it's saying it's about 73 inches wide. I'm gonna add some bleed to it, to the height and width, and bring it out there. I'm gonna actually just add extra bleed to the height if I can, just so that they have room to move when installing, to move the wrap up and down to get it aligned better with the side fender. All right. And then, so I have another example down here in the program I was gonna show you guys. Yeah, this wrap, who would wanna install a whole bunch of straight lines? All right, so I'm gonna go to my mask layer and I'm gonna, you know, drop the opacity down real quick just so I can see the body lines again. I'm going to do the same thing and I'm gonna draw the box. And then I'll bring the opacity back up. And I'm gonna take that and I'm gonna drag it over here. And this should just kind of get me an idea of where the lines are gonna line up. I'm gonna release the clipping mask. Now I'm just gonna just use my arrow buttons and I'm gonna use my left arrow to scoot this completely over the hood. Or I could probably drag in place if I have a steady hand. So by using that box and lining it up with the top of the roof, like I said, as long as you, like for this instance, like I just wanna add extra bleed to the height again so I have wiggle room. So when installing, if they need to move it up or down, they can get it exactly where it needs to be. I can go to my template layer and copy the hood, control B, paste in place, arrange, bring it to the front, make clipping mask. All right, so that's my best tips and tricks on how to do that. I also wanted to show you guys something really cool, this art project we've done before. All right, so we actually took this piece of art and someone's daughter actually painted this on a canvas, and he went and got it professionally scanned in and sent over to us, and he's like, I want to wrap my car in this. And you just see this flat piece of art and you're like, how am I going to make it fit a car and make it flow? But we got a little creative with the install, because, you know, this is, you know, putting this on the side of a vehicle and getting it to look seamless around the bumpers and fenders and hood is really hard. But there's actually a lot going on in the painting, so to our advantage, it helped us. But I'm going to kind of just show you what we did on the install side to make this wrap look like it flows. All right, so let me pull up our next image. So here's a completed wrap. If we zoom in here, I mean, I don't know. Can you see any visible seams on that you can point out? So actually, oops, let me zoom. Zoom in. Believe it or not, this is how we did the seam. So we picked the side. I clipped part of each part of the art, one for this side, one for the other side, pieces for the back, and I just made it fit this car, make it work. So we took our side panels and they wrapped them all the way to the end, and then he actually put seams. So he seamed it right here over the trunk, as you can see where I'm scrolling my mouse, where it followed a piece of the line of the artwork, and then seamed it here onto the trunk hatch. And then if you go down here, down below the light, he seamed it right here along this rounded part of the painting. And it actually made the wrap flow like really well. And there's just different parts of the wrap that we did this on too. Let me see if I can pull up another image. This is just how you gotta get creative. Me and the installer took the artwork, they laid it on the car, and we're like, how are we gonna make this fit and look great? And like, as you can see here on the front of the car, you wouldn't know where we put our seam. I'm actually not even really sure where we put the seam. So like, you know, here's the break of the car is normally where you would end a print and then start the whole bumper. But I think we actually seamed, we drew maybe that line, followed this black piece of art to make the seam. I mean, like I said, it was really nice because the art was very busy and distracting that it helped us out a lot. But, you know, you just got to get creative and figure out how to make it work best for you and your installer. That's all I got for you today, guys. I hope I helped you out a little bit on the whole fender to bumper to hood. I know I didn't give an example of the bumper. The bumpers are just most difficult to do with templates because I don't, you know, a bumper has so much curve to it. And the best way to get something, if you want it to print and end exactly, is to go out there and physically measure the vehicle. Take your measuring tape from one corner where the bumper completely ends, like right over here, and go all the way around at the widest point and go to the other edge. And you just gotta, you know, make notes and make marks on where things need to line up, and just write it all down and get it drawn out. And sometimes you might have to make adjustments to a template and move things, and just to get it to work for yourself. I mean, templates are designed a certain way so that, you know, you do have extra bleed in certain areas. If I were to take an actual image of this truck and lay it under the template, you would see that like every body line wouldn't line up exactly, but it's because when you're designing on the template, they want to make sure that you have enough bleed in certain areas, and maybe some areas are a little longer than they appear than looking at the side of a photo. So maybe this part is actually longer than it actually appears in the photo on the template, because you have to account for the curve of the vehicle that goes around to the front of the headlight where the hood and the fender end. All right, well, stay tuned for more videos. Thanks, guys. See you later.